Hello friends, here we will discuss about the design perspective of the amplifier. We will take one particular problem which is based on common source, common emitter, two-stage amplifier. So we will look at particular example where we'll have to design the CSCE multistage amplifier. Here you have the problem and they ask us design a RC coupled two-stage CSCE multistage amplifier with the following specifications. AV should be greater than or equal to 1000. RI, that is input resistance, should be much more than that of 1 mega ohm. Stability factor S should be less than 8. FL, that is low frequency, low cutoff frequency, is 20 hertz. And VDD or VCC, that is nothing but the DC voltage, whatever is been given, is 20 volts. Okay, so whatever five quantities are given to us, and based on that we have to design our amplifier that is of two stage. Okay, so first of all you should keep this in mind that whenever you have to design the CS amplifier or CSCE amplifier, they might not give you the particular CS or CE amplifier. How we can analyze that, how we can judge that whether you have to use CSCE amplifier or CSCS amplifier or CCE amplifier? Let's look at this particular gain. Gain is greater than 1000, it's not greater than 9000, 8000. Okay, so once it is greater than 1000, I can achieve this gain by assembling two stage amplifier with one as a low gain and another as high gain, so that product will become your near to your 1000, and that will be greater than 1000. Of course, more than that, I have to have input resistance is 1 mega ohm, and 1 mega ohm input resistance is possible only when if I apply JFET as your transistor. So JFET amplifier mein hi I can get the RI as 1 mega ohm. Okay, so it's already been concluded that from RI is greater than 1 mega ohm, I have to use CS as first stage because RI is 1 mega ohm. I can directly say that RG is equal to 1 mega, and that will become your input resistance. Stability factor is given, that means that you have to use your BJT as well. So it becomes a simple to judge that yes, here we have to use the CSCE amplifier, that is of two-stage amplifier. So let's look at the particular design problem, how to solve this. First of all, I will write the step number one, right? Step number one. Here in this particular step, we first analyze what should be the gain of first stage, what should be the gain of second stage. Okay, so as I said earlier, it's your design, so you choose your values, but keep this in mind that whenever you are using JFET as an amplifier, you will not get much more gain than that of your BJT. Okay, so keep first stage as your JFET, second stage as your BJT. Okay, so what we will do here, selection of transistor. Okay, selection of transistor. Now we will say for first stage we will use FET, right? And that is of BFW 11. For first stage we will use FET, that is of BFW 11. For second stage we will use BJT, and that is not yet included. Okay, which one, BC547A or B, right? So that we will conclude once I decide the particular value of the gain, expected gain. Okay, whatever gain is being asked, that gain is greater than 1000, that is been asked, that is given value. Okay, I want to split this gain into two parts, one is AV1 and another is AV2. So we'll say that let AV2 is equal to 200. If AV2 is equal to 200, I can say that AV1 is equal to 5. Right? Clear? You can change your values like 150 and 9 or 10 or 8, like. So depending on these values, we'll be getting the particular values of resistances. But make sure that your this particular gain AV1, that is of JFET, that should be less than 10. Okay. So this should be less than 10. Okay. If it is less than 10, it will become very easier. I will not decide on the threshold values. If I take 10 here, I will take 100 over here. But if I decide 100, then that will be a dilemma for me whether I have to take the BC547A or B. Okay. So here I will decide that here it should be 200 and here it should be 5. Okay. So now I have got the value AV, which is AV2, which is greater than 100. So I will use the value BC547B. Now I can conclude that whatever BJT I am using, that should be of type BC547B, not A, because gain is greater than 100. Okay. Now let us start with your transistor specification. Okay. So for BJT, now let us assume that data sheet is not given. Now try to get those particular values, right? So try to pause your screen and try to write that particular values of your rated values of BC547B, okay, and BFW11 as well. These are the particular values of BJT. BFW11, FET ke liye, I will be having the values, very simple, RD is equal to 50K ohm, then I can say IDSS is equal to 7 milliampere, then VP is equal to minus 2.5 volts, and the last one is GMO is equal to 5600 micro mho. So all the specification we should keep in mind while designing your amplifier. Let's begin with the first step of your design, that is nothing but your second stage, step number 2, and here I will write the design of stage number 2. Okay, while designing stage number 2, the first step for the designing is nothing but calculation of RC. Okay, here I will not write RC2 or RC1 because I know that C is only once, right? Because BJT and FET both are there in stage 1 and stage 2 respectively. So calculation of RC mein kya aayega? First of all, we'll say that what is AV2? AV2 is nothing but minus HFE upon HIE multiplied by RC. Okay, so what we'll have to write? HIE for BC547B, HFE, that is HFE AC, and that we have to take it as a typical value, HIE value, RC value, that we have to find out. So what we will write? RC is equal to AV2, that we have decided that 200. So 200 multiplied by HIE value is 4.5K divided by HFE value. What is value of HFE? HFE value is 330. Okay, calculate that particular values. You will be getting 2.73 kilo ohm. That is the value of RC. So what we will write? We will write the first value, standard value of your resistance towards the higher side. Of course, we will be getting 2.8 kilo ohm with 0.25 watt. Okay, so this is your first value, calculated value for second stage collector resistance. Okay, as far as collector resistance is concerned, that is okay. Now we will move towards the step number 3. Step number 3 is nothing but the calculation of Q point. Now when we'll decide how to calculate the value of Q point, let's discuss further. By midpoint biasing, okay, So by midpoint biasing, we will decide what will be the value of ICQ, what will be the value of VCEQ, and so on. I know that the value of VDD is been given, that is nothing but 20 volts. So here we will write that given value is 20 volts. So we'll say that VCEQ, what's the value of VCEQ? We have to take the half of VCEQ. So we'll say that this is nothing but 20 divided by 2 is equal to 10 volts. Okay. More than that, I will write it over here. Whatever the value of voltage across the RE resistance is 10% of the value of VCC. So we can say 10% of VCC, that is nothing but 2 volts. Okay. Now these things are familiar to you all now. VCEQ is 10 volts, VDD is 20 volts, VRE is 2 volts. So what we'll have to do, by KVL at the output, here we will write what, how we'll get the KVL. See to it that this is the stage 2. This is the calculated value of RC, just now we have calculated. This is unknown value of RE. Here I'm taking as ground, this is the particular value of VCC, and this is the value of VCEQ. Okay, so as far as this particular KVL is concerned, we will say that we'll start from here, VCC minus ICQ, I will write, multiplied by RC minus VCEQ minus voltage across RE is equal to 0. Right? VCC is known to us. VCEQ, just now we have calculated. VRE is known to us, just now calculated. And RC is known to us. We can easily calculate the value of ICQ. So ICQ is equal to VCC 20, VCEQ 10, VRE 2, right? Divide by the value of RC, just now we have calculated as 2.8 kilo ohm. Okay, so let's calculate this particular value. So your value of the Q point collector current is nothing but 2.857 milliampere. Okay, once we get this particular value, we will move ahead to calculate the value of RE. So here we will stop for this step number 3. We will say that Q point is nothing but VCEQ comma ICQ is nothing but VCEQ, we have decided that half of VCC, that is 10 volts, and ICQ is 2.857 volts, milliampere, I'm sorry, so milliampere. Okay, now we will move ahead for step number 4. So for step number 4, we have to decide what will be the value of RE. The value of RE is nothing but voltage across RE, that is known to us, 2 volts. And just now we have calculated the value of ICQ, that will be same as that of value of IE as well, because beta value is much, much greater than that of your 100, right? So what we will do, as beta value increases, your alpha value tending towards 1. So I can say ICQ is nearly equal to IEQ. So we'll say that here ICQ only, as IEQ is nearly equal to ICQ. Okay, so what we will calculate, 2 divided by 2.857. So calculate this particular value. This value comes out to be 0.7 kilo ohm. That means 700 ohm. I have to take this as this is equal to 700 ohm. Okay. What we will do? We will take this RE standard value towards lower side, and that will be 680 ohm with 0.25 watt ratings. This is your second calculated value as far as the second stage is concerned. Let's move towards the calculation of R1 and R2. Okay, so we will move ahead for the step number 5. Step number 5. Let us move ahead for the step number 5. Step number 5 is calculation of R1 and R2. Okay, so what is R1 and R2? These are nothing but the base resistance. Okay, so R1 and R2 I want to find out. So stability factor is given as 8. We'll take this as a given value. I know that what is stability factor. Stability factor is nothing but 1 plus beta times divided by 1 plus beta times Re divided by Rth plus Re. Okay, this is the value of the stability factor as far as voltage divider bias is concerned. I have specifically used voltage divider bias. This is because I know that as stability factor is less than 10, I have to use voltage divider bias, because voltage divider bias is a more stable circuit whose stability factor is less than 10. So we'll say that as S is less than 10, use voltage divider bias circuit. Okay, so let's assume that this beta value is much greater than 100. I can say that this is nothing but the beta. So we will simplify this particular thing as beta, and this 1 plus beta is also will get cancelled, and this part Rth plus Re divided by Re, that will form 1 plus Rth divided by Re, right? Now this, with this particular formula as well, we can calculate the value of the Rth. So we'll get the value of Rth as, this stability factor is 8. I will write directly as 8, which has been given. 8 minus 1, that is 7. 7 multiplied by 680 ohm. And that is nothing but your Rth expected. 4.76 kilo ohm. That's nothing but the value of. Okay. Now, okay, fine. I have got the value of Rth. How to find out the value of R1 and R2, right? Separately. So for that, we will use one another trick. Let's say we'll use this particular space. I know that whatever beta value which has been given, right, that is very high, right? So IB value is very less, so the voltage drop across this Rth is very less. So I can neglect this particular part, and I can say that directly whatever voltage that I will be getting across this particular VBE and this RE is nothing but the value of Vth. Okay, so here I'll say neglect voltage across Rth. Okay, now I know that this is VBE is 0.7, and this particular value across this RE is VRE, that is 2 volts. So 2.7 is the value of the Vth. So I can say that Vth is equal to 2.7 volts, and this is nothing but, as far as the formula is concerned from VDR, we'll get to know that this is nothing but the R2 divided by R1 plus R2 into VCC, right? And this is how we'll be getting the value of the VD. This is R1, this is R2, grounded, this is VCC. Okay, so we'll be getting this value of Vth over here by using VDR. Okay, I can say that VCC is known to us. I will say this particular ratio I will be getting, and that I'm writing it as Vth divided by VCC, that is nothing but 2.7 divided by 20 is equal to R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Okay, and that is coming out to be, can say that R2 divided by R1 plus R2, that I will be getting as 0.135. We'll say that this is equation number 1. Okay, and then I know that what is the value of Rth? Rth is nothing but R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2, right? But here we will be getting that this particular ratio R2 upon R1 plus R2 will be carried out by the first equation itself, and only one unknown will be left in this particular equation, is nothing but R1. Rth is known to us, we have calculated it as 4.76 in the previous step, in this particular step only, and now we will be getting the value of this particular RTH new equation will be 4.76 kilo ohm. That is nothing but the RTH. Okay, R1 is unknown, right? And this particular value is nothing but from here, right? And we'll say that this is nothing but 0.135. Here we will be getting the value of R1 as 4.76K divided by 0.135, 35.26. Okay, that is a calculated value. I want a standard value. So R1 is equal to 36 kilo ohm divided by 0.25 watt, and that is nothing but the calculated value and the standard value of R1, first resistance of base. Second resistance of base we can get easily, very easily, by just putting the values of R1 in this particular equation. We will be getting the value of R2 itself, right? So what we will be getting, R2 is equal to, R2, calculate the value of R2, 5.48 kilo ohm. That is a calculated value. I want a standard value. Again, I will write it at lower side. We have to take R2 standard value, that will become 5.4. It is written, I'll take 5.2 kilo ohm with 0.25 watt. This is the calculated value that we have already calculated. R1, R2 is done, RE is done, RC is done, Q point is also done. So second stage is all done. Now we will move ahead to go for the design of stage number one. So step number six, design of stage one. Okay, now we are moving from output towards the input side. So we will be writing over here calculation of, first we will write the calculation of, first of all we have to go for the Q point, because unless we calculate Q point we cannot move ahead for the gain as well, because GM is one unknown, one agent is there, right? For that we have to calculate the value of VGS, Q and IDQ. So calculation of Q point, will say that quickly, use midpoint biasing. Using midpoint biasing, keep this in mind that don't use VDSQ as half, right? Use IDQ is equal to IDSS divided by 2, right? Because we are operating this particular JFET in saturation region, not in active region as that of BJT, right? So use midpoint biasing, will say that ID becomes IDSS divided by 2, and that will become, IDSS is 7 milliampere for this particular transistor. We'll be getting 3.5 milliampere, that is nothing but the value of ID. Okay, similarly, once we get the value of ID, we have the value of IDSS here, right? IDSS is equal to 7 milliampere, GMO is equal to 5600 micromo, and VP is equal to minus 2.5 volts, and that has been given already in the design rating parameters. IDSS, GMO, VP is done. We will calculate the value of VGS. So from equation, ID is equal to IDSS, okay, in bracket 1 minus VGS, Q will write for both VGSQ and IDQ, VP the whole square, okay. What parameters are, which parameters are known to us? IDQ, just we have calculated, ID itself is IDQ for us right now in this particular design. IDSS is 7 milliampere known to us, VP is known to us, only one parameter is unknown that we have to calculate, okay. So let's begin for the calculation, calculate the value of VGS and can come to me. You'll be getting minus 0.73, so minus 0.73 volts as your VGS. Q, okay. So VGSQ, as far as VGSQ is concerned, it is all done. Now what we will be doing, we'll calculate the value of GM, okay. GM is equal to GMO multiplied by 1 minus VGSQ divided by VP, okay. VGSQ is 0.73, VP is equal to 2.5, and GMO is equal to 5600 micro mo. So with this calculation, we'll be getting the value of 3.96 milli mo as the value of GM. Okay, so calculate this value and tally this value with 3.96 millimo. Now, once we get the value of GM, we'll move ahead for the value of RD, right? So first of all, we will complete this particular step number 6 by just noting down all the values of Q point. Here we will write the Q point as Q parameter VGS Q and ID Q is equal to VGS Q is -0.73 and ID Q is equal to 3.5 milliampere. Okay, and then we will say that we will move ahead for step number 7. Step number 7 is nothing but the calculation of RD. Okay, calculation of RD is been done by using the formula of AV1 is equal to GM into RD, right? But in parallel with all the resistances, input resistance of the second stage, that are nothing but I can say R1 parallel R2 parallel HIE, right? Many a times you people do mistake by not taking this HIE into this equation. So you have to take the AC analysis, you have to take the AC equivalent model into picture and take all the parallel combination of all the resistances, right? So in this particular equation, all the values are known to us. AV1 is known to us, which has been decided as 5. Then GM is 3.96 millimo. R1 is known to us, R2 is known to us, and HIE is nothing but the rated parameter. What we'll have to do? We'll have to calculate the value of RD, right? So pick up your Calci, check your Calci is working or not, and pause your screen, come to me. ₹4.93 is nothing but the value of RD that we are be getting. Okay, so the value of RD is nothing but 4.93 kilo ohm. What we will decide, we will take these values at the higher side, right? So what we'll take, RD is equal to 5.2 kilo ohm. Okay, so 0.25 watt, that is nothing but the first parameter of stage number 1. RD is done. Now step number 8 is very simple. How we will decide the value of RS? So it's a very simple trick to design the value of RS. So let's see calculation of RS. So RS, as far as RS is concerned, let's draw this particular circuit here. We know that the VGS, now to calculate the value of RS, we'll say that this is the RS, this is VGS, and this is a ground. I can say that as far as this particular voltage is concerned, this resistance is self-biased configuration we are using, and this RG is nothing but the higher resistance, which is should be greater than 1 mega ohm. Forget about all these things, but I know that the voltage drop across this RG is equal to 0 because current will not flow through the gate side. So gate current is equal to 0. So I can say that whatever value VGS that will be getting, that is nothing but the value of VRS, but with the negative sign. So VGS is equal to minus of VS, right? And that VS divided by the value of ID is nothing but the value of RS. I can say that this value of RS is nothing but VGS minus of VGS Q divided by ID Q. Okay, so all the Q points are there with me. We can say that this VGS Q is nothing but minus of minus 0.73 is nothing but 0.73 divided by 3.5 milliampere, and that is coming out to be 208 or something like that, 208 ohm. So I'm taking the RS standard value of the resistance as 200 ohm at the lower side, 0.25 watt. This is the second parameter of stage number 1. And now we have to move ahead for the simple calculations. These are nothing but the step number 9. This is a selection of RG, not the calculation of RG. I'm saying that I'm assuming that the value of RG should be greater than 1 mega ohm. I'll select one particular resistance as it should be greater than 1 mega ohm. I'll say select RG is equal to 1.2 mega ohm, right? One can decide it as a 2 mega ohm or 2.2 mega ohm also, no problem at all, right? But unnecessary, don't put it as 10 mega ohm or 56 mega ohm or something like that, right? So we'll say it should be greater than 1 mega ohm. So 1.2 is enough, I guess. So RG is equal to 1.2 mega ohm. That has been done. And then I'll say this, I'll directly write it as a standard value, 0.25 watt. And this is nothing but your third parameter, which has been selected for the input resistance, gate resistance for stage number one. So now crucial part, last part is been left. That is nothing but step number 10, calculation of all the coupling and bypass capacitor. So calculation of bypass and coupling capacitors. Okay, so what we will do, we will just put the formula, right? CC1 is nothing but 1 upon 2 pi into R into FL, right? The formula of FL I'm using, right? FL is equal to 1 upon 2 pi R and C. So I've taken as CC1. I want to calculate the value of CC1, 1 upon 2 pi R into FL. FL is known to us, right? So here we will write the FL is equal to, how much FL is been given? FL is equal to 20 hertz, it's been given. And well, value of R is nothing but RG, right? So calculate the value of CC1. You'll be getting 7.95 nanofarad. And I will be taking it as a standard value, CC1 standard value, that will be 10 nanofarad at the input side. So again, the ratings are along with the voltage for the capacitors. So voltage has been given as 20 volts. So we'll keep it as 20 volts itself. Okay, this has been done. Then we will move ahead for the CC2. CC2 is equal to 1 upon 2 pi R into FL. Whereas FL is already been given, R is nothing but the RD1 plus the value of RB, that is nothing but I can say, I'll write it over here, R1 parallel R2 parallel HIE. Okay, so calculate this particular value, put this value in this formula and get the value of CC2, right? That is left to you, 2.26. This will be 7.46 kilo ohm. It's been 1 microfarad. The value will become 1 microfarad. That is the value of CC2. I'll keep this value as standard itself. The value is CC2 standard. I will keep it as it is. 1 microfarad with 20 volts. That is nothing but the another parameter of your capacitor. So next capacitor value will be calculating CC3 as your bypass capacitor of stage number 1. So 1 upon 2 pi into R into FL. What's the value of R? R is nothing but RS in parallel with 1 upon GM. Okay, so that GM is nothing but 3.96 millimo. This comes out to be 111.6 ohm. Value is coming out to be 71 microfarad. Okay, so here I will take it as A2 microfarad, or you can take it as 100 microfarad as well. We'll take it as 100 microfarad with 20 volts. Then we will move on for stage number CC4, right? So here we will name it as CS, first emphasize CS for bypass, and this will become CC3. So CC3 is your output stage of output stage number 2, 2 pi R and C, where R in FL, where R is nothing but the value of RC. RC will be getting directly from the stage number 2 car design, 2.8 kilo ohm. So we have got the value of RC as 2.8 kilo ohm. And put the values, get the answer, pause your screen and calculate this particular value. 2.8 microfarad. Right? So CC3, that coming out to be 2.8 microfarad, I'll take it on the higher side. So CC3 is, let's say, 4.7 microfarad, no problem. This is my design as far as CC3 is concerned. So let's move ahead for the last calculation parameter. That is nothing but CE, that is bypass capacitor for stage number 2. So 2 pi R into the value of CFL. And the value of R is nothing but the value of RD1 plus your value of RD1 in parallel with your R1 in parallel with R2 plus your value of HIE divided by the value of beta, that is nothing but HFE AC value, right? HFE AC value. And that will be in parallel with the value of RE. So value of R is coming out to be 20.98 ohm, and that will give you the value of CE with higher side microfarad. It will give you 3979 microfarad. So we'll keep this as, keep it at a much higher side. We'll take it as CE as 470 microfarad with 20 volts capacity. Here we will say this completes your design. As far as steps of the all the parameter calculations are concerned, we have finished. Now the important last step is remaining, that is nothing but the step where we have to draw the circuit with the design parameter. Here we will be getting, this is 470 microfarad, CC3 is 4.7 microfarad, then the value of CS is 100 microfarad, the CS is, this is CS, this value is to be CS. Then the value of CC3, CS and these values are done. Then CC1 is 10 nanofarad. This value is 10 nanofarad, so 5.2 kilo ohm, and this is your 36 kilo ohm. The value of RC is coming out to be 2.8 kilo ohm, and the value of RE is 680 ohm, right? All the values are done. Here you have to write which transistor. Here it is BFW11, here it is BC547B. Okay, so this is how we have completed the complete procedure of designing of CSC multistage amplifier. Thank you so much for watching this particular video. If you have any doubt, any sort of doubt, so please write on comment box of this after this particular video and subscribe this particular video. So thank you so much. Learn more and more EDC along with me. Learn more and more EDC with Ikeda videos. Thank you so much.